Hey, this is Ben, and you're listening to the Hot Dog Answer Man, and today I'm going to be doing a video cast showing you how to create your own magic button, a secret magic button. If you haven't heard about it, check it out over at learnhotdogs.com and check out the magic button article. It's pretty amazing. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to promote your business quickly and easily using Facebook and Twitter. But first, I'm going to show you the Facebook. And what I did is created you a short link. So we'll go up into your address bar on the top of your browser. And all you do is type in, I made a short link. So just type in learnhotdogs.com/FB for Facebook and hit enter. That should pull up this Facebook page. And on this page, you will see you have local business or place, a company, organization, or institution, brand or product, cause or community, entertainment, artist, band, or public figure. And you could use any of those you wanted, and now you know where to find it. But we're going to use local business or place, and then we have to choose a category. So first we're going to run down here real quick and pick a category. I would suggest either food, grocery. You could do event planning, event services. You could do local business. That's also on here, right there, local business. But I'm going to use food and grocery. And then we're going to call it Magic Button Hot Dogs. And then we have to use an address, so we're going to use 485 Main Street, and we have to use a real town. As soon as you start typing in your city, it'll have a drop-down list. Just pick it and hit enter, and it fills it in for you. It auto-populates, they call that. And then you just type in your zip code, 37862. We're just going to make this up, and then let's do 111-5555. And then you have to agree to the Facebook terms and conditions. You can read that here, and you put, I agree, get started. Phone number is not valid. It recognizes that that's a fake phone number. So let's try 217-8111 and get started. And it let us in. I do not have a Facebook account. Now you can choose, if you already have a Facebook account, you can link it to your personal account, or you can just create it separately. And it'll let you log in separately. And you can even later make yourself an admin and still do everything you normally do. This keeps it separate, you know, business from personal. And it's kind of cool that way. Now, I use the I don't have a Facebook account. And then you have to have an email. I set up an email just for test purposes to do this. And it's called magicbutton1@yahoo.com. And I'm going to make a password, PASSWRD1, password 1. And let's see if I did that right. Okay, and then you have to put in your date of birth. Even though it's a business page, they want a date of birth. So let's just pick one. We'll do May 2nd, 1962. Okay. And then they give you this crazy looking code, and what that does is prevent computer bots, these internet bots that go out and make fake subscriptions and stuff. This can prevents them from signing up, and it almost prevents us. Sometimes you can't read it. And so it looks like an ELOSTSTA. And then you have to put, I have read and agree to the terms and conditions, blah, blah, blah. Sign up now. The text you entered did not match. So what it's going to make me do, which means the text I entered for this did not match what I wrote. And so I've got to put my password in again. And the birth date stayed in there for me. And it says MIFELFG. I don't know what that is. An OCTST. And I'm going to hit enter. And it let me in. So what I'm going to do now is go to my email and inbox and see if I have an email from Facebook. And I'm looking, and I'm seeing a welcome. Let's go to inbox again. There's really not a refresh. If there is, I don't see it. I could always hit this and see if that refreshes it. One and unread email. There it is, Facebook. So it took it just a second to get there. Once it gets there, there's a link inside of it. See how that lights up as soon as I hit it? I will click that. That opens up Facebook again, so I don't need that other page open anymore. And it's going to open up here in a minute. It's going slow for some reason. So we will wait. In fact, I will smoke a cigarette while we wait. Okay, so now we've got, you can set a profile picture. And all you do is upload one or import one from a website that you have. So we really don't know about a picture there. So we could just pick a random picture from the computer. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to just pick one from my computer. You should have files and stuff. Like I've got stuff listed here. So what I will do is I know that I have one on my desktop, and that's the one I'll use. And that uploads. And then I hit next. And then you can do a description. It says, add a description and website to improve the ranking of your page in a search. So you could put, you know, we are a hot dog cart, we do private parties, and we do this and that, and we serve this and that. You could put your menu if you wanted, but if you have a website, you can link it in there as well. I'm just going to put test, the awesome magic button. And then you could put a website. Well, I don't have a website to link to this, so I'm going to hit save info. And it's still wanting a website. Let's see. If you don't have a website, let's see if it'll let me pass this without a website. Save info. Yeah, just take out the website information and let you do it. So here's our Facebook page. It's ready for us. And now all we do is you can add a cover to it. Like if you want a picture of a hot dog, you could add that picture to it and you'd have it in there. And you can play with all these settings. You've got different privacy settings. You've got your information here about your business and you can change that. You can change your photos anytime. It kind of gives a timeline of when you were opened, joined Facebook and such and such. This part up here, your visitors never see. This is for the administrator of the site, and it tells them something like, you had 19 people visit your page in the last 30 minutes. And then it'll tell them if they liked anything or saw anything or shared a picture or if they added a picture. You can set it set up automatically where anybody can come in and add a picture. You know, they can hit this button and add a picture for you. They can tell something, hey, I stopped by Magic Button Hot Dogs today and it was awesome. I love their spicy mustard. And so you can do all of that from here. Add a cover just puts a real pretty background picture. Like if we visit, I'm going to do one for you here real quick. If you notice, this is that picture. And you notice I don't have this set up right now as an admin. So right now, this is, this doesn't show me that admin section. It does tell me there's, you know, 7,220 likes, there's 153 people talking about this currently, and there's 32 were here recently. And so it does do that, but it doesn't, you know, it doesn't show the admin stuff. That's just for you. And so if I had logged into this with my admin, it would show me all that information, this information on the top. So that's all there is to setting up a Facebook business page. And now you've got something you can link to your customers. You can share it with customers. You can get them to like your page, and they'll do it for you. And if you want to spend money, you can actually advertise this page on Facebook. But I wouldn't suggest doing this. There's no reason to, because you'll have friends that'll start sharing it, and you'll go, hey, like my page, and it's here. And once you get going, instead of this being this long code here, what it will end up being is facebook.com/magic-button-hot-dogs. And you can even shorten that. They have ways to do that in your admin, your settings area. So there's lots of things you can do here, but I would suggest if you don't have one, to go ahead and set one of these up, and you'll enjoy it, and you'll be able to interact with your fans and friends.